Hey guys, it's Dee from Dee's Divine Guidance, and in this video, I'm going to tell you three reasons why you are energetically attracted to the bad boys. We all know it. We've all been there. If you're watching this video, those bad boys really do us in. We're attracted to them, yet we are left feeling in pain and hurt and all of that stuff. But before I do this, make sure you hit the subscribe button below and give me a thumbs up if you're really excited to hear these three reasons why we're energetically, not mentally, but energy-wise, why we're attracted to these bad boys. All right, so let me start. Number one is because most of us, and I really think all of us, because we come from the same energy, the universal energy, are empaths. We want to help others. We feel other people's energy. And when these bad boys come to us or when we see them in our sights, we don't have to talk to them. We already can feel their energy because let's get it straight, right? Bad boys come from a place of low vibration because they're hurting somewhere in between. Bad boys like narcissists, not even sure they have vibrations. Just kidding, kind of. But you know, so they're coming from a low vibration as it is. So when we see them, we don't even have to like talk to them, know them at all, but we can just see them and we know that they're bad boys because we're feeling that energy and we're feeling that bad boy. And as an empath, we want to help. And we're like, ooh, this is a project. And especially if you're codependent empath, we are definitely like, oh, this is our guy because we can help them feel better. We can help them get happiness. We can be there for them and help them through whatever they're going through. So our energy feels their energy. And as an empath, we're like, we take that on as our own. We feel as though their energy is our energy and we want to help and we want to fix. And that is why one of the reasons why we are energetically attracted to these bad boys. All right, number two is because of our past relationship. So I had a client one time say that, you know, oh, I know he's a bad boy, but I just want him. I just want him. And, you know, and she's like, but usually I always go for the bad boys. And I'm like, well, why? And she's like, I just have to have him. And she wouldn't listen to anything I had to say. And the reason for that, and I told her, I didn't think she likes it, but I tough love guys, but I had said to her, well, let's think about why you like this back and forth, these ups and downs. Let's think about your past. So the second reason why we're energetically attracted to these bad boys is because they remind us energy wise of our past. So most likely if you're watching this video, you are either a codependent person, which means just means it doesn't mean that you're dependent on other people, but it does mean that you're seeking validation for yourself outside of yourself. So when we go with these bad boys and they go up and down and up and down, they like us, they don't like us, we break up, we get back together, like this roller coaster rockiness, we're used to that somewhere in our past. So if that is you, think about your past. Was it your dad? Was it your mother? Was it your sister, your brother? Maybe it was another relationship when you were really young that treated you like this. And you just got used to the fact that you would have to go overboard to get somebody's validation for yourself. You also got used to the way that they treated you. You would get used to the silent treatment. And we start to get addicted, kind of, but energetically attracted to the drama, to the ups and downs, because if something's not happening, then we're bored. And it's because in the past, we have been so used to it going up and down, up and down. You know, if you're a child of a narcissistic parent, I'm pretty sure you probably got the silent treatment, or maybe your brother or sister got more attention than you did. So there's something in your past that is keeping you energetically attracted to these bad boys, the rockiness, the, oh, I have to get that because it's a challenge. And I know I grew up, like it was always a challenge for me to, you know, get the love and get the respect and get what I needed from my parents. My, you know, my father wasn't around, my mother was working all the time and I had to go overboard. So when we're attracted to these bad boys, it's like a, oh, I can get this. I can get this. And it's also going to bring you more validation when you do. So if you are a codependent person and you are seeking that validation outside of yourself, when you go and you're attracted to these bad boys, when you do get their love, it feels so good. But then when they take it away, or even attention, not just love, but even attention, when they take it away, right? When they don't call you when they said they would, or when they sleep out, when they're supposed to be home, like that's taking it away from us. And as an empath and as a codependent empath, we are like, whoa, 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 that's like the total opposite of validation. And we start to, okay, we got to get them back. We got to get them back. We got to get them back. And it's a vicious cycle that we go through when we are attracted to these bad boys, because we're constantly trying to seek our validation inside of that relationship or whatever you want to call it. But they're out doing whatever they want. And it feels good for us to hurt. Get that through your head. It feels good. It feels familiar for us to hurt. So when it's going too good, and I just did a self-sabotage in the Facebook group, but sometimes we even self-sabotage ourselves, like causing the fights, because if everything's going too good, we're not used to that. And like something's wrong and we have to stir up some drama. So again, energetically attracted to these types of people. And this is bad boys, but it could be bad girls if you're a guy watching this. But we are energetically attracted to these people because they are keeping us in familiar energy. It is the energy that we're used to. It is our comfort zone. And we all know, if you've followed me for a little bit, I always talk about the ego and how the ego wants us to stay in our comfort zone. So when we have a bad boy in front of us, we know the deal. We know what we're about to go through. We know what we're about to embark on. We know that it's going to be drama. Yet we go after it because that's what we are familiar with. That is where our energy is in the most comfortable at that point. The third reason here is because you have low self-worth. So again, this is a little bit similar to number two, where it's about past relationships. But somewhere along the line, in those relationships, you actually established a very low threshold of self-worth. So you don't feel as though you're worthy. I know I went through times where, you know, I was a business owner, I had money, like all of this, but I still didn't feel worthy of people that were the same as me, having a business and having a lot of money. Like I'm like, oh, they would never want me. They would never want me. And that is because I went through so much in my childhood that made me feel unworthy. So I didn't think that I was worthy of the men that I knew would be nice to me. And, you know, I get some business people are not nice and they're narcissists as well. But I remember dating somebody and he was too nice. He was too nice. I actually literally said, I don't know what to do with you. I don't know how to handle him. And it was because he was too nice. And because I didn't have the self-worth at that point to realize that I deserved somebody like him. Where was the drama? Where was all the hurt? Where was all the pain? It wasn't there. And because of a low self-worth, I needed that drama. I needed that because it validated me and then didn't, and then validated and didn't, and did it and did it. Where being completely validated all the time was boring to me. So you have to realize that, you know, these roller coaster rides that you've been on your whole life, and also the self-worth that you don't have about yourself, that you don't feel like you're good enough to get the type of guy. And it's even like, you know that you're good enough, but it's your energy that says, no, not for us. Remember, no, that good guy that you once had, nope, he left, right? And we start to, the ego starts to play on us. So if you have that low self-worth, you want to make sure that you start to increase it and start to see how worthy you are. And in doing that, you know, I do energy healing. I'm an intuitive energy healer, and I help women empower themselves after toxic relationships. But when you are going through all of that and you have low self-worth, you have to, before you start going after those bad boys, because you already know what it's going to bring you. You already know, you already see the red flags. But what we do is we stop and say, oh, we could fix that. We could fix that. Oh, that's not that bad. At least he does this and he has this and he does this. But I can deal with him going out late at night. I can deal with him not coming home. All of that is just bullshit, guys. It is bullshit. And you really have to kind of find your self-worth in order to stop being attracted to the bad boys. And this is that self-worth goes along with everything, goes along with your body and your mind and your relationships. Once you know your worth, you're not going to settle for the guys that treat you like shit. And these bad boys are going to treat you like shit. Bottom line, they're going to treat you like shit. I'm at the point where I'm waiting for the nice guy. Not the nice guy, the kind guy, right? I don't like the nice guy because the nice guy, a little bit codependent. We might do another video. Let me know in the comments below. Like, you like these videos. Let me know if you want me to do more on like codependent guys. Because I find that a lot of the nice guys are codependent guys. And I really just want a healthy, healed, kind person. So I hope this video was helpful. Please make sure you subscribe. I also have the Get Over Your Ex Challenge. So if you are struggling with getting over your ex, these bad boys, because again, we're so used to that roller coaster ride, I have the Get Over Your Ex Challenge just in time for Valentine's Day. If you're interested in joining me, I'm going to be doing it in the group. I'm going to be doing a lot of coaching. So I'm going to be coming live to actually answer your questions along with the videos that you get in the challenge, okay? If you're interested in that, you can check the description box and the comment below. I hope to see you there. It's going to be interesting. We're going to do it the week before Valentine's Day. All right. Or actually, I think it's the week of Valentine's Day, which is going to be exciting. All right. So don't spend Valentine's Day with the wrong person, with the bad boy. Find your self-worth. See your past for what it was. And let's get through all of that. Disconnect from your ex. And let's go on to find a healthy, kind relationship for you. All right. Let the energy go. Much love to all of you. Have a wonderful day. And I will talk to you soon. Bye.